Hey guys and gals, this is a quick little update for Saba. I had someone ask, and I actually told myself, write down who asked, so you can thank them for reminding you. There you are. Thank you for asking. I totally forgot how much of a pain it is to change the batteries in Saba. I think I've only pulled the cover off once before doing the actual video. I've done it a couple times since, and it is a nightmare. The instructions say, get an item, like a screwdriver, go in at an angle, and then push, like this, and it will pop the battery cover off. I think the general idea is that there's meant to be a divot inside, and when you go at this angle, you're sliding the whole thing back, the whole row. I don't know if maybe when I got mine I was too forceful. It looks like inside that it's pretty scraped up, and I don't see this kind of system lasting very long. And since they have screw protectors, or screw covers on the whole thing, getting inside there to fix it or to change it is not going to be easy. I think my best bet right now is to drill a small hole inside the little plastic, just to give me more of a channel to kind of work, all that kind of thing. So, this is going to be hard to show on camera. This really is, and I hope I can do it. So, what works best for me, get a screwdriver, get one that fits in that hole pretty well. If you can get one that has the least amount of a point as possible, that might be better in terms of not scratching things up. But you're supposed to put it inside, and then for me, what works best is going straight down, pushing in the plastic, and then kind of, there you go, doing that. And it pops right out. So, it is a very terrifying kind of thing. I'm going to try to show you. Let me zoom in just for a little, see if this helps. So, the way it works is, when you push down on this, see if I can show it. You see, it does that, and it doesn't move enough. You're supposed to kind of get it at an angle, so the whole thing kind of slides back. You see, the whole thing is meant to go back quite far. It's a very strong spring, actually. I just think that maybe the first time I did this, I could have broken off that one divot. So instead of having that to catch on and being able to slide like this, it's just this back one. And based on that it works for me now is to actually push inside the plastic, get enough friction where I can actually slide it back. So let's try this again, see if I can do it. And when you're done, just put this back in and push. It's terrifying. So let's try this again. So again, for me, I have to go straight down. Try at this angle. The instructions advertise this angle. But if I push there, and then kind of there. So there you go. The more I do this, the easier it is getting. I'm gonna let you know, the last time I tried to attempt this video, it took me 6 minutes to finally get this open. So it definitely takes some messing with, some playing. Do not have a very skinny point that will scratch at the plastic. This might be your best size screwdriver. You need something with leverage and a small bit to get inside there. So there's a odd hair inside there. So I hope this does help with you. If you have your Saba and you need to replace the batteries, I don't think I've had to replace my batteries since, and I've had this for a year. So hope it's something you have to really do. And you see there's some black plastic that's scraped off from the inside of that thing. It's such a weird little system, and I don't understand why they did that. I don't like that at all, and I hope the future Legacy figures don't have such a thing in place. But there you go. I hope this was some help. Here, that worked best. For your Saba. And again, thanks to you right there for bringing this to my attention, because I totally spaced and forgot just how much of a nightmare it is changing the batteries in this thing. And I hope I never have to do it, at least for another decade. But anyway, thanks for watching as always, guys. I will see you around. Take care.